Hello and welcome to the 2014 MCLA National Championships broadcast in partnership with the Lacrosse Network. We're here in Orange, California at Ernie Chapman Stadium on the campus of Chapman University for today's Division I semifinal, the Nightcap. I'm Chris Marshall, joined by Trey Lanthier, and we have got one heck of a matchup between the number one team in Arizona State, undefeated coming into this game, and the number four seed, Chapman Panthers, playing at home in the jungle. As always on these broadcasts and every broadcast we brought you this whole week on MCLA.us, these are fully interactive, so make sure to send your tweets, comments, questions, anything you got to us at CMarshallTLN, at Trey Lanthier. Use the hashtag MCLA2014. And Trey, there are no shortage of superstars on these teams, but who is the man for Arizona State?
You have to look at Zach Handy, the faceoff specialist, won SLC Defensive Player of the Year. You look at those stats right there, 77.4% in the faceoff circle. Almost nobody gets through Handy.
And Handy, the MCLA Player of the Month just 1 month ago. Now Chapman has an ace up their sleeve as well. What can you tell me about Timmy Andrews?
He's got 48 assists. That's 10 assists more than anybody else in the MCLA Division I. The next is Kyle Posler from Westminster. Timmy Andrews is the best distributor in the land.
Now a man you know very well, an intense fellow, Chris Malone.
Yeah, he's one of those guys that has that look in his eyes anytime he's getting ready for a game. Chris Malone, in his final season at ASU, looking to cap it off with a championship.
And looking very sharp, coming into this game undefeated on the year. And we've got Dallas Hartley on the other side of the ball.
Yeah, Hartley, a guy who's been a solid coach at Chapman, and he's brought his team to this Final Four appearance. They're, again, looking to try and get into this championship game to take on Colorado, who won in the last game.
And Dallas Hartley coming from local powerhouse La Costa Canyon High School, state champions coming up, and here we have how they got here.
Yeah, if you look at the left-hand side of this bracket, Arizona State knocked off Boston College in very close fashion, while Chapman just manhandled Colorado State.
And now we have the national anthem. There you have it, getting a look at the fans, and they are fired up as well, singing the entire national anthem. This building is electric tonight, near capacity tonight, complete sellout, all the tickets gone, and they're just as fired up as we are.
A rivalry game, two teams that are definitely not strangers. They've been playing in the SLC, the WCLL. They go way back, and this is one of the biggest matchups these two teams have ever played. A championship appearance is on the line.
And these two teams, in the last 6 years, both making two appearances in that final game. Neither one of them able to come away with the victory. So a lot of pride on the line for these two squads. Arizona State taking the first two meetings this season, once in the regular season and once in the SLC championship game, in pretty dominant fashion. But the Chapman team that came to play that day was much different than the team we saw on Tuesday.
Yeah, and something Coach Hartley said that really stuck with me was that it's very difficult to beat a great team three times. And Chapman's already lost twice to Arizona State. If Arizona State wants to complete the sweep, they're going to have to play a great game, especially with how much momentum Chapman's bringing to this one after their dominant win over Colorado State.
And the party caps are already hopping on the sideline for this Chapman Panther squad playing at home in the jungle. And you see these goalies coming in, touching hands, and we're ready to get this game underway.
Both of these teams have had championship aspirations since the start of the year. ASU has yet to lose, but Chapman, they haven't faced too many losses in a while. Arizona State being the only team to beat them since all the way back through the first five games of the season.
That's 15 games going through 14-1, rattled off 13 in a row before losing a close one to Arizona State. And you can hear the Panther fans cheering on Chapman, and no shortage of Arizona State fans here as well. You see Brendan Courteau coming inside, losing the handle, and that one goes back out to A.J. Rafter. And the Panthers getting the first offensive possession of the game. None of the Panther fans have sat down yet. It is going to get rowdy.
Yeah, both of these teams have always been longtime rivals, and it's going to be interesting to see if we get a defensive battle or if we get an offensive slugfest.
I mean, these are teams that can do both.
Yes, exactly.
See Rafter up top. I think Rafter is the real wild card for the offense of the Panthers. He's a guy who has the ability to absolutely take over the game. We talked about Andrews and his ability to cut the defense up behind the cage, but Rafter, absolute rifle coming from both of his arms.
It's not going to be easy against this ASU defense, though. They do not allow many goal scorers to find their way into more than a couple goals at all season.
An interesting look having Ancarlo at X and Andrews on the crease. Used to seeing Ancarlo on the crease for this Panther squad. Ancarlo cuts back, looking for the feed, and so crafty. As he comes in looking for Marshawn. Marshawn takes the shot just off the mark, and that one dropped right back into the crease for DeLuca. DeLuca sends it down the field. And now the Sun Devils off to the races as Wadella brings it across. Arizona State in the all gray with black helmets. Chapman in the black jerseys, white shorts, white helmets. And these teams look sharp.
Yeah, and the heat has been a factor all day long, but I don't think it's playing into this matchup too much. Started off late enough to where it's cooled off down on the field.
Definitely turf temperature up near 130 degrees this afternoon. Much cooler now, the sun down, the breeze has picked up. As you see, the Sun Devils going to work. That one sneaks by the pass they were looking for in the middle, picked up by leading scorer Justin Straker, and back up top to Denis.
Yeah, Straker came up with a game winner over Boston College in the second round.
Dan Davis, and Dan Davis working on Dutra, the senior. Denis going on Rafter. Back up top to Quinn, the captain. Has the pole matchup, gets the switch now on Rafter. Quinn trying to use his body, get inside. Nice pass to the backside, and back up top to Denis. 12:25 to go in the first quarter. And you can hear the fans. They are really letting this Panther squad hear it. Local product, Cooper Pakel at a Foothill High School, just 3 miles down the road. Dan Davis looks like he likes this matchup. Just under 12 to go. Coming inside, takes the shot. That one just off the inside pipe.
Yeah, I'd expect to see a lot of that from Dan Davis. He's been finding the twine multiple times on the season. He's been a dominant force to be reckoned with all year long.
See Denis dodging from up top, gets to Pikel. Pikel takes the shot and scores the goal. Breaks the seal as the Sun Devils get on the board first.
Warren Nielsen only allowed 2 goals all game against Colorado State in the first round. In this case, the second shot he faces is the one that gets through. Cooper Pikel from outside. He can target any corner of the net. He does it right here to get past Warren Nielsen and put the Sun Devils on the board first.
And Cooper Pikel, a player who had 4 pipes in the game against Boston College, finally getting off the schneid as he's able to put that one in the back of the net.
And you can see the replay right here as Denis on the nice feed. Cooper Pikel had enough time before the defense could collapse.
And there's Handy winning it back to himself again, and he's going to be working on Croteau all night. Croteau, a very large, athletic, long stick middie, coming in at 6'4", 230. And they're just going to let him have it as he's running away from it. But the ball brought across by Beecham. 11:20 to go in the first. 1-goal lead for Arizona State. And make sure to send your tweets in. Let us know what you think is going to happen in this game, who you're watching, where you're watching from, how you're watching. Anything you want to tell us, love those comments. Fully interactive broadcast. Send those tweets in at CMarshallTLN. It's Finn Wells trying to get free. Under 11 now. Great switch coming around the corner, and that one's going to go out of bounds, backed up by Wells. And we talked to Coach Malone pregame, said that he wanted to go through 3 lines of middies in this first quarter. Wells comes around the corner, fires it back down to Straker. See a flag down, sorry, and theirs comes. Flag down to see a step in the crease. And you can see what this call is going to be for. Had the official outside of his pocket. It looks like this one's going to go against the Panthers at the 10:34 mark. Got a tweet coming in. This one from Brad Gregory Bochessa. Chapman Lax fans screaming the national anthem was awesome. Love the spirit. Couldn't agree more. That was an electrifying moment here at Estadio de Ernie Chapman.
Brad Bochessa, superstar out of Sonoma State, one of the leaders in the MCLA in points this year. Glad to have you tuning in, Brad. And an ASU chant now resounding from the stands.
Again, 10:54, or 10:34 rather, to go. Dan Davis going to bring the ball in for the Sun Devils. Big opportunity for Arizona State to go up 2 goals early in this game. Pikel up to Quinn. Quinn cross crease. There's the pass. That one too tall. But going to be backed up by Arizona State. Straker working from X. Back up top to Quinn. Now under 10 minutes as we see back to even strength as Chapman subs through the midline. There's the shot again, and that one top shelf coming from Justin Straker, and that's a huge goal for the Sun Devils.
And Straker strikes early, does it a lot. He's been doing it his whole career, the senior, finding the twine once more, and Warren Nielsen giving up his second goal of this first quarter. And you see Cooper Pikel loses that one, has to shovel it forward. Great feed from Quinn and Straker. No doubt about that one.
And now Arizona State has equaled the total number of goals of both of the first two opponents for the Chapman Panthers. Northeastern only able to muster 2. Colorado State only able to get 2. And that second one was garbage time in the last minute of the game.
Yeah, and ASU, a team that does not typically start out fast. So this is a page from a different book right now that ASU is pulling out.
And you hear the Chapman fans letting DeLuca hear it as he's gonna bring it across. And no stranger to having athletic goalies is now you've got Alex Siegel all over him, and he's way on the other side of the field. And you're gonna hear the timeout call coming and see if it's gonna go the other direction. And Coach Malone able to get the timeout called as DeLuca barely gets into the box.
And I'm not sure against a defense as stout as Chapman's you ever want to be taking a risk like that if you're Chris DeLuca. The offense has been feeling it. They've been moving the ball well. No need to take an unnecessary risk. But you can see the ASU sideline clearly fired up about that. For the first 5 minutes of this quarter, Chapman, on the other hand, has got to figure something out here, Chris.
They definitely do. I mean, Chapman, a team, as we look into their huddle now, it's a very emotional team. They ride high highs,
yes,
and they ride low lows. So if they're able to feed off the energy here in this stadium and get something rolling, they could be a very dangerous team. But if they dig themselves an early hole, it could be a long night.
Yeah, and something that we haven't touched on too much, though, is that this ASU fan base has also shown up to represent in the stands. I mean, I wouldn't say it's an even split, but it's at least 60-40 or 65-35. These teams are doing a great job of showing the MCLA why, as you see these fans showing up. And
haven't sat down the whole game. They're up here. They're rowdy. They're getting excited for the for this side of the game as you hear them chanting, cheering for their squad, but standing up this whole time and really letting the Chapman boys know that they have this this whole side of the stadium, as some of the Arizona State fans trying to wander into the student section over there, not having a whole lot of luck. But got a great tweet, this one coming in from fellow SLC player Paul Morgan, captain of that Cal State Fullerton team that had a fantastic year this season. Power cut off at my house due to San Diego fires. Watching TLN from the parking lot right now, rooting for Chaptown. Paul Morgan, that, my friend, is commitment. Again, 9:20 to go. Arizona State with the ball, up two goals. Coach Malone able to call that timeout as DeLuca got just barely into the box before losing the handle with stout defense from Alex Siegel. And there's a great check, knocking the ball out of Davis's stick, rather, as Dutra all over his hands. Again, look for Chapman to mix up their defensive looks quite a bit. They play a very high-pressure brand of defense, and they'll be sending a lot of pulls out there. You see Cruteau coming through. And then Laviola, able to kick it to himself, picks up the ball, running down the sideline, flips it back, no-look pass into Andrews. And what a spectacular play to keep that one in, and the fans are fired up.
And this is the first time we've really gotten to see the Chapman offensive unit set up.
Back down to Ancarlo, 8.5 to go in the first quarter. Now Giannotti. And watch Cruteau, 14, in the middle of the field as he tries to create a matchup problem. Rafter's going to come on. They're going to have numbers as they find Rafter coming through. Giannotti doesn't throw that one out in front of him, but Rafter, with a world of speed, tries to turn the corner, gets it down to Ancarlo. Now up to Jenkins and over to Giannotti. The team speed for the Chapman Panthers, impressive.
Impressive to say the least. As we saw that team go crazy against Colorado State in the last round.
And Aberzazi, Rafter, Giannotti, the first line midfield for the Panthers. Giannotti loses his foot and keeps going. See Aberzazi creeping up all the way up top to Rafter. Rafter 20 yards out. Coming inside, goes to his left, rolling back. It's Aberzazi coming inside. Rafter looks like he likes his matchup, sends it back down to Giannotti. Marshawn, another one of the exciting attackmen for the Panthers. Aperzese cuts back to his right hand, looking inside for Andrews. Andrews takes a shot, scores the goal, snatches that one right out of the air, makes DeLuca pay.
What a turnaround, and you can see the Chapman sideline getting fired up. You can hear the fans going crazy, as this is going to be a rowdy atmosphere from start to finish, especially if they're turning dimes like that.
And Andrews, when he gets his hands free at that point in front of the goal, you see him back cut, inside, turn around, change the plane, go five hole on DeLuca. There's nothing you could do about that.
And Andrews isn't a guy who scores often, but you see right there, he has the offensive potency to do it.
And DeLuca, again, he was in perfect position to save that ball and just even better shot.
Yeah, as Ryan Davis, former Arizona State goalie, tweeting in, he's watching this game with Payson Clark, Sam Lockett.
And that's a big-time hit. That one's high.
as Nicky Mullins and the fans disappointed.
Andy has collapsed on the field.
And this could be a big play for Arizona State as he took a humongous hit from the freshman Nicky Mullins.
Oh my gosh, Zach Handy does not look good. He was trying to come off the field and could not make it to the sideline. Trainer's coming out.
And they're looking to check out the local product. Again, Zach Handy had a historic season even. Fantastic player out of Foothill High School. High school teammates with Cooper Pickell. As we see the replay here, turning the corner as gets absolutely blindsided, lifts up his head, comes in low, and that one helmet right on the chin. And that's a tough one. As he turned right into that one, Mullins had his hands out in front of him, but looked like he caught him with the helmet first. Tough to get low at 6'5" tall. Takes it to Handy on that one, and that was a pretty, pretty brutal hurt. Handy coming in at 5'10". And still down on the ground.
Handy'd won 3 faceoffs in a row coming into this, and definitely not a guy you like to see go down. And a lot of fans have gone quiet at this point. You can see even the Chapman bench has gone to their knees. This is great sportsmanship from the Chapman sideline.
Well, and that's one of the things you see from these SLC teams. There's a lot of camaraderie between these squads. A lot of local kids on this Chapman team as well. Some high school teammates of Zach Handy and some friends. So nobody wants to see anybody get injured on a night like tonight, where so much is at stake for both of these teams. You see Handy able to sit up. Looks like he's going to be able to walk off under his own power. And you hear the fans, both sets of fans, Arizona State standing up, Chapman standing up, cheering the big fella off as he walks himself off the field. But I suspect this is probably the last we're going to see of Zach Handy.
Yeah, I can't imagine him returning after a hit like that. But props to the fans, props to these two teams for just great sportsmanship all around in a play like that. But now, getting back into the action out of this break, remember, Arizona State up 2-1, but Chapman currently holding all the momentum in this one.
Again, Arizona State stepping up. You see all of the Arizona State fans letting their boys know that they're here to watch as well. Just under 7 minutes to go, 1-goal lead for Arizona State. Cooper Pickell bringing the ball in. Davis to Straker, and they're going to swing it back around. Nice cross, crease look, and that one just too tall for Quinn. And you see the sideline for Chapman getting amped.
And that's usually a catch that Quinn is able to make, and right there. Couldn't find the ball to his stick.
And remember, Arizona State still up a man as they're doubling the ball. Nielsen walking it up. Looking for somebody. Gets the ball to Herman. Herman loses the handle. Straker on a line, trying to get to it. Nielsen out of the cage. Nobody in the goal. Comes around the corner and scores it. And an ill-advised play by Nielsen after Herman loses the ball costs them a goal. And that's a huge momentum shifter.
Absolutely. Not a great play by Nielsen, but give credit to the heads-up play of Justin Straker. He's a senior captain on this team, and look at him pick up the loose change after this drop ball, chases it all the way down near the end zone line, and then races back to put it away. Justin Straker is feeling it here tonight.
And Arizona State absolutely going to need that. You see a new faceoff player coming onto the field for Arizona State, and that's Cortland Jones, the freshman at a Brophy Prep.
Cortland Jones has not seen much time in the faceoff circle.
He's working on Simon Jenkin, and Jenkin able to pick it up. And this could be a huge momentum shift for Chapman if they're able to start winning these faceoffs.
Absolutely. It's not something ASU is accustomed to dealing with.
And there you see only the 29th faceoff taken by Cortland Jones. Giannotti getting the ball up top. Under 6 minutes to play now. Marshawn, back behind the cage, moves it to Andrews. Andrews feeling this matchup out. Working on Matt Wallace, the freshman out of St. Mary's High School in Annapolis, Maryland. Rafter now with a head of steam has the pull. Opts to move it back to Giannotti. 5:20 to go in the first. 2-goal lead for Arizona State. Arizona State still a man up. Surprised they're not doubling the ball. Rafter still with it. Back to Giannotti. Now back to Andrews. It's like Arizona State trying not to overextend themselves as the penalty has now been killed by the Panthers as they held it for nearly 90 seconds after giving up that first goal. I mean, sportsmanlike conduct for the high hit going against Nicky Mullins, an unreleasable penalty, would have been an opportunity for Arizona State to really get rolling on the offensive side of the field as they could score as many times as they want without wiping away the flag. 4:30 to go. Chapman now with the ball. Still in this first quarter. Now Giannotti. Nice swim move. Coming inside. Takes the rip. That one over the top of the cage, backed up by Marshawn.
Yeah, this Chapman offense has been finding opportunities sparingly.
Marshawn turns the corner, rolls back to his left, trying to find some room, and nothing there as he's going up against the senior, Ian Connell. Ian Connell, interesting matchup there, going against Marshawn rather than going against Andrews. And then Rafter able to kick it to himself, but can't come up with the ground ball. And there's a big hit as you see the flag. And Nick Hillier coming in with a high hit. And the refs really trying to take control of this game.
And I don't fully blame them, because this is a game that can get out of control with the crowd atmosphere, with the rivalry, no love lost between these teams, as we see the replay right here. And Hillier definitely came up high with that stick.
So Chapman now with the opportunity to go man up. Our first look at their man up offense. We're going to go to a shot of Zach Handy. He's here on the sideline going through some of the concussion tests, it looks like. Got some blood on his jersey. Hope that he is all right as we get a closer look.
And it looked like his chin was a little scuffed up.
Trainers making sure that he's going to be okay. And that's certainly the most important thing here tonight. It's like Coach Hartley wants to talk it over.
Yeah, and clearly Chapman, it definitely doesn't feel like a 3-1 game that ASU is leading right now. With the momentum shift we've seen since that Handy hit, it's been a lot of Chapman. They were able to kill off that penalty that came after the Handy hit. And also, they've moved the ball well on offense.
Yeah, I mean, this Chapman Panther team starting to feed a little bit off of the crowd noise here. 3:36 to go. And really going out there and trying to put something together. You see Coach Hartley talking to his boys on the sideline and trying to draw something up to get them a shot going. And you see Coach Malone taking a sip, having some water, telling his boys, get out there and play the game. And make sure to join the discussion. Tweet at us at #the_MCLA, #MCLA2014. Tweet at us. We'd love to hear your tweets. @CMarshallTLN, @TreyLanthier. We'll get to as many of them as we possibly can. We've gotten a bunch of good ones. One coming in from Carly Simo, watching on the big screen tonight in Sacramento, looking for her brother, Sammy Simo, unfortunately sitting on the sideline with an injury.
Yeah, and I got a tweet in here from Ryan Davis, former ASU goalie, as I was saying a little earlier, watching with ASU legends, Payson Clark, Sam Lockett, and John Little, all of whom were vocal leaders, revered and respected in that ASU locker room. And Payson Clark just graduated today. So a shout out to Payson Clark.
Congratulations. And a lot of Chaptown alums in attendance here as well. As you can see, the stands packed to near capacity, a complete sellout. And Giannotti from outside, that one just wide, but backed up by Kelly. And Kelly not getting the start after having a big game against Arizona State and a pretty solid first two round games. Back up top, Giannotti, 3:15 in the first. Reagan Kelly trying to send that one in to Ancarlo, can't find it. Connell has it, trying to roll away from the pressure. Aperzezi knocks the ball out of his stick, can't come up with it as the ball's still down. Andrews trying to get it. You see 5-6 players going over that direction, and it's going Arizona State's way.
And the sideline for the Sun Devils was emphatic after that turnover.
Back to DeLuca, under 3 minutes now in the first. Still 2-goal lead for Arizona State.
And Chapman going to bring a tough ride here. Interesting decision.
We're seeing them try and force DeLuca to bring the ball across himself. We've seen a lot of teams go to this, matching feet as they come across and try and force him to do it. Down to the last 10 seconds, he's got to get it into the box. As he comes down the field, looking to take the shot, and he does. And that one hits his own man, but he's got a hustle to get back into the cage as Croteau takes the ball away from Dan Davis. Now Nielsen with it, almost loses the handle, but able to move that one to Nickelman. Now Nickelman looking up the field, finds Nicky Mullins.
And DeLuca has made it back into his cage.
And Andrews does well to come all the way back up to the midline and get that ball for the Panthers as we now eclipse the 2 minute mark to go in this first quarter.
Yeah, both offenses have really stalled over the last couple minutes.
It's just tough defense. Andrews now has the shorty. This is the matchup they've been looking for. Looking cross-crease to Kelly. Kelly can't come up with it. That's a great pickoff play from McEnany. And McEnany sends it back to DeLuca after rolling away from the pressure.
McEnany, also a local SoCal product.
It's right out of Rancho Bernardo High School in San Diego. Waddella now with it. 90 seconds to go in the first. Standing room only in the Chapman section. Tyler Buck with it. Gets it back from Beecham. Minute 15 seconds to go in the first. Rafter takes the switch. Now working on Straker. This is the matchup Arizona State wanted. Expect to see that slide coming early from Nicky Mullins. See Straker clearing out. Cuts back, slide coming across, moves it inside, but that collapsed defense too much as the Panthers come inside. 48 seconds to go in the first. Beecham with it up top. Dan Davis now. Back down to Straker again, still working on Rafter. Rafter pushes him outside, back up top. 35 seconds to go in the first quarter. Beecham has the shorty working on Giannotti, likes his matchup. They push the crease way back. Go for the one-on-one as he stops, rolls back. 20 seconds now, full head of steam, tries to get by Giannotti, does, looking for the feed, can't find anyone, and that one is overthrown. 14 seconds to go in the quarter. Chapman gets the ball back right at the midline, and you can see the coaches yelling at their players to get up there and take advantage of that quick whistle.
They're gonna have time to work with here.
And that one batted down by Straker, ball still on the ground. And picked up, going the other direction. And now Arizona State needs to get a shot off with one, and that's it right at the buzzer. But a great effort from Dan Davis. What a quarter.
Yeah, both teams going back and forth as Arizona State came out on top, and a pretty strong start. But here we're gonna have sit down with Coach Hartley on what it means to have home field advantage here at Ernie Chapman Stadium.
Fired up. tons of Arizona State people here, tons of Chapman fans here. School still in session. Got a 3-1 lead for Arizona State. And this game, I mean, what more can you say? It's very exciting.
Yeah, and I mean, who would have expected anything else? The Arizona State team that was been number one almost all season long, taking on longtime rival Chapman, and in a battle right now, as a 3-1 lead definitely doesn't tell the story of this game. It's been back and forth. Chapman has been playing their hearts out, and the Sun Devils are trying to keep their offensive momentum going strong.
Looks like
in the second quarter,
Jenkin taking on Jones. And like I said earlier, I suspect we've seen the last of Zach Handy, probably for the tournament. That ball's still down. Jones doing well. I mean, he's a guy who lines up against Handy all day, every day in practice. Jenkin able to come away with it. Nice swim as he comes down the lane looking to take the shot. Does, just off the mark, and that one's going to stay with Chapman. Now Laviola in. Moves it to Jenkin. Back up top to Welch. See Chapman, a little bit different look than we've seen from them, with Laviola and Welch coming in as part of that third line midfield for the Panthers. And that one almost picked off by Connell, but Kelly able to come away with it. A minute gone in this second quarter, still a 2-goal lead for Arizona State.
Yeah,
Welch now top.
Hard to believe that Chapman's only scored one goal in this game. Feels like they've been getting a lot more opportunities.
I mean, it's hard to believe it's only the second quarter. Feels like we've been up here for quite some time. Zancarlo, the senior, trying to create some space, but McEnany all over his hands. Jenkin gets it to Welch. Welch has the pull over to Laviola. Hearing some vuvuzelas even in the crowd tonight. Over to Laviola. Laviola thinks about the shot, gets it to Andrews. 13:20 to go in the half. Andrews rolls back, and that's where he's so dangerous. Always has his head up. Look for Ancarlo as they move the ball to keep his feet moving on the crease. Now subbing Rafter back in through the box. Laviola gets the quick double, moves it to Ancarlo, and Carlo to Andrews, sorry, to Kelly. Kelly to Andrews, and they're moving the ball very quickly as they get the ball to Rafter. Rafter takes the shot, and that one off the mark.
Offensive momentum is in Chapman's favor right now as they're definitely picking up the pace and forcing this Arizona State defense to keep shifting and wearing down those legs.
And those are those same goals they scored against Colorado State early in that game. Look for them to keep feeding the crease. And Carlo has been an absolute beast for them inside this season. Welch now trying to find some space. A player who had a lot of playing time early in his career. And Carlo turns the corner, takes the shot. Great save by DeLuca. That one's going to stay in, but he's got Kelly coming his way and just barely gets by both of those players as he's able to move the ball up the field. And Connell now with it moves it to Cooper Pickell.
Great evasiveness from DeLuca on one end, setting up ASU's offense on the other.
Just over 12 minutes to go in the half. Pickell now with it up top. Looking for Denis, finds him. Denis now working on the shorty, Herman. Herman with two goals against Colorado State. Had a little bit of an offensive explosion. Again, moving it back up to Quinn. Now Pickell, back down low to Dan Davis. See, high pressure again. That looked like a moving pick, and that's what they're going to call him for. Dan Davis looked like he was trying to get out of the way, trying to be sneaky on that one. The ref's not letting it fly. Sending it up to Nickelman. 11:15 to go in the first half. Dutra now with it, has Laviola in the center as he gets it, gets out of the sky, up to Herman. Herman looking, no look pass, there's the one to Kelly, and Kelly swings it across to Ancarlo. and he buries the quick stick goal. Tic-tac-toe, the lead is one.
And Carlo was in perfect position. He knew exactly where he needed to be for his teammate to hit him in stride right into Luca's face, and he buries that one. Beautiful goal-scoring effort, Chapman. That's near perfection.
I mean, it's so unselfish.
He barely even caught the ball, just pushed it forward.
And you see Kelly, the finisher, as he was dubbed by A.J. Rafter post-game on day one. Really making it look easy as he sends that one into Ancarlo. And then Miller out to take the faceoff going against Jones. That one picked up by Croteau. As he rolls away from the pressure, ball still down and picked up. It's going to be a procedure call going against Arizona State. This crowd is so rowdy. You see a bunch of standing room only fans down on the sideline watching their boys go to work.
This could very well be the best crowd I've seen at a lacrosse game of this caliber.
Yeah, I mean, it's certainly the biggest crowd I've ever seen at an MCLA game.
And what does that say for the sport?
I mean, it's exciting moment for all of these fans here, the Chapman fans, the Arizona State fans, and just plain fans of lacrosse in Southern California. And you hear the Chaptown chant coming from the sideline. Aperzezi. Rafter. 10:15 to go in the half. One goal lead for Arizona State. Kelly working on Connell. Again, you see the freshman-senior matchup on both sides of the attack. You've got Connell taking on Kelly. And you've got Wallace taking on Andrews. As that one passed through the crease, can't find his man as Arizona State gets the ball back with 9:52 to go in the half.
Yeah, and something we haven't touched upon yet, Chris, is the fact that there's a lot of seniors with a lot of history in this league who are playing in this game right now, none of whom have won a championship.
And the seniors part of the first class of, if you will, of the SLC. So certainly some pride at stake as these guys have been going at it, splitting SLC titles over the last 4 years. Back up top, has a head of steam. That's Wells. Trying to make something happen, taking one in the elbow there. No slash call, moves it to Straker. Back up to Beecham. Tyler Buck. Working on Giannotti. 9 minutes to go in the half. Straker versus Nickelman. This has been a matchup they've liked to go at. Trying to get his hands free inside, takes the shot. That one off the mark, but a solid effort from Dan Davis, even able to get that shot off through the tough defense of Dutra. Now all the way up top to Beecham. Beecham has an angle, takes the shot. Big save by Warren Nielsen. And that's a sky ball.
Yeah,
must have gone 40, 50 feet in the air.
Nielsen only recorded a couple saves in this game so far, but that's a big one right there.
And it's such a momentum position in the goals. You see the replay on that one. Did well to track that. But such a momentum position. You make a couple of good saves like that, and it could be game over for the other squad. Beecham now trying to get by. Beecham has been one of the most dangerous options so far. Nielsen saw that the whole way right out of the stick of Wells. And this crowd, they're so rowdy. This is great.
Yeah, and you can see him on your screen right there as one of the best showings you'll ever see in a lacrosse game at any level.
And we got another tweet coming in, this one from former All-American long pole from Chapman, Nate Barris, tuning in. So a lot of fans watching. You got a lot of legends from Arizona State. Got some coming in from Chapman. Everybody's watching tonight. 7.5 to go in the half. It's Riley working with it, gets it down to Marshawn. Again, Chapman going through that four-man rotation at the attack. Riley now up top, working with Herman. And Zervis. Chapman looking for their matchup.
That's great defense on Zervis. Zervis swims through the double, looking across the crease, can't get it there. Ball still down. It's like Chapman's got a line on it. There's three black shirts inside. No one seems to be able to pick it up. Finally picked up by Arizona State, and they're off to the races. That's Hillier, loses the handle. Nickelman coming in on Straker. Straker can't pick it up. Finally does, fighting through triple team. Dutra, no hold call. And there you have it. A hold going against Chapman, but a lot of commotion there as the ball picked up by Davis, as you hear the quick whistle.
Yeah, that's one of those wild plays that can go either way, and this time went in ASU's favor.
I mean, and those plays are extremely dangerous with these offenses. Both Arizona State and Chapman, very good in transition. When you've got guys who've been there before, guys like Straker, guys like Davis, Straker picks up the ball, he'll find the closest guy to the goal who's open, and they'll have a one-on-one more times than not. Just over 6 minutes to go in the first half. One goal game, Arizona State holding on to the lead.
Yeah, and Warren Nielsen in the last round played perhaps the game of his life against Colorado State. And if he can rediscover that rhythm, he could
Denis
be
all fitting. The way across looking for Quinn. And Quinn takes one in the back, no possession, as Mullen steps over.
And Quinn clearly not happy with getting shoved in the back like that.
Mullen's definitely a bruiser out there tonight. And there's the BTB, tries to make it as Denis. Would have been a spectacular play. Actually improved his angle on that one, and Main runs it down. Quinn back up to Piquel and over to Denis. 5:20 to go in the half. Denis has the shorty. They like this matchup. Trying to roll free. Loses the handle. Taking some serious shots to the side there. Ball still down. And finally picked up by Riley. Riley cutting away. Trying to fight through it. Moves the ball. No call on the push. Refs letting him play. Croteau in there, throwing big checks on Piquel. Piquel able to get away and moves it to Straker, who comes all the way up from X to get it back to Quinn. Watch out here, unsettled situation as Quinn looks to get the shot. Now under 5 minutes to play in the half. Quinn has the matchup with the shorty. This is a good matchup for Arizona State, and you see the flag come down as Dan Davis trying to pick it up. Nickelman gets it, and it's going to be on Chapman, probably for a slash.
Yeah, it's actually Quinn looked inside for Davis, trying to find him on this bounce pass. But a call going against Chapman, and the fans not happy with the call.
Displeased.
You can tell this Chapman fan base goes deep.
They're a fickle bunch.
They are a fickle bunch. I would agree with that much.
But this is a big opportunity for Arizona State to extend their lead back to match their largest of the game. Denis going to start with it and move it up to Piquel. Back to Denis. Watch for Straker creeping on the backside. And there's the shot. No problem for Nielsen. Again, we see these lefty goalies really give people problems sometimes as Herman rolls into the double. Thought about sending it to Jones, but opts to hold on to it himself, moves it back to Nielsen. 4 minutes to go in the half. Nielsen lets it fly, looking for Marshawn. Marshawn able to get under it, and that's Kelly. Kelly through traffic, gets onto the ball. And Dallas Hartley with the timeout. What a heads-up play.
And that's a big swing as you've got to respect Nielsen going for the long pass there. We're under the four-minute mark to play here. It's hard to believe Chapman is trailing in this game. It certainly does not feel like that's the case, as ASU has had a couple offensive possessions go their way, but Chapman has really been controlling the tempo, the pace, and the flow of this game, and I think a lot of that is coming from this crowd atmosphere, but more importantly, just from the hits being laid on, these Chapman players are playing as well as you could hope for them to do so.
Under 4 minutes to play now. Chapman with the ball on the offensive side of the field. They'd love to get a goal here. And remember, join the conversation. Send us your tweets, questions, comments, anything you got at CMarshallTLN, at Trey Lanthier. Love to hear from you, where you're watching from, who you're watching.
how you're watching, and go ahead and throw a couple personal questions in for us. We'd love to hear from you guys on Twitter, again, at CMarshallTLN and Trey Lanthier.
Yeah, tweet coming in from former Sun Devil Sam Lockett asking us to look at the extensive cabbage, flow, and lettuce on the ASU roster as it's ridiculously luscious. And I have to agree, there's a lot of guys that have beautiful flow.
And we're going to go back to this Warren Nielsen save that we saw in that last play. Ball coming across, shot from outside. Here's Beecham. And watch as you see the slow-mo goes from low to high, gets that with the top hand, and fires that ball up into the air. I mean, that's a fantastic save by Nielsen, and he tracked that the whole way off the ground up towards that top corner.
And the play in the faceoff circle since the Handy injury has been 3-0 in Chapman's favor. They've been playing excellently well to take advantage of the fact that Zach Handy is out of this game.
A.J. Rafter working from up top. Back to Giannotti, getting another look at this first-line midfield from the Panthers. Down to Marshawn. 3:40 to go in the half. I mean, this game is already so tense. This feels like there's 3:40 to go left in the game. Neither team wanting to make a mistake at this point. Still just a one-goal lead for Arizona State. Aperzezi by his man. Nice look across, finds Marshawn. Marshawn buries the quick stick. And again, Chapman finding the crease look.
Marshawn showcasing his legendary speed as he works his way into the crease area to put that one home. Chapman has tied this game up and getting another look at this play.
And Aperzezi just runs right by his man. And you see that second slide coming. That one's coming from Wadella. He just doesn't get there in time. And the easy quick stick goal for Marshawn.
Marshawn, the backdoor cut, and caught this defense off guard. And we're back to a tie game.
Again, tied for the first time since 0-0. That one pulled back. Simon back to Croteau, and that's a heads-up play. Everyone going forward gets it to Laviola. Now with just over 3 minutes to go, Chapman with the opportunity to take the lead for the first time. Laviola inside, off the pipe. That one back out, picked up by Jones. Jones runs into the double team, loses the handle. That one going towards Ancarla, who gets it. And he is able to run away from the pressure. And you can see Andrews calling for the team to slow it down a little bit. The senior trying to get his boys all on the same page. 2:45 to go in the half. They'd love to go into the half up a goal.
Well, they've been playing great in the offensive set. You want to keep going to the game plan you've been playing all game long.
Marshawn coming around the corner, gets it back up to Herman.
Interesting to see Marshawn getting the look from Ian Connell, the number one long pole for the Sun Devils.
Yeah, we talked about that. Has the freshman Wallace going against Andrews. Clearly saw something on the game tape from the last time these two teams played, forcing them to make that change. Nice look inside by Herman. Again with the skip pass. Loses the handle. That's great defense. And now Arizona State off to the races. It's like Hillier thinking about the shot, takes it, scores the goal. And he's got new tires because he just went coast to coast.
Hillier is ecstatic right now. He has every reason to be the senior captain. Nobody's earned a goal more than that. Is a coast-to-coast finish. He scoops it up on one end, runs all the way the other direction, and smartly, he takes this shot exactly when he needs to. The defense is about to rush up on him. He has just enough time to get that low left corner, and he does it to perfection.
Yeah, and forcing Chapman to have to make that move in the rotation and give them Dan Davis or Straker on the backside. And that's going to be a hold going against Jenkin, and with 1:50 to go, Arizona State with the ball.
And that's the first faceoff that Cortland Jones has won since Zach Handy's injury.
And got a tweet coming in. Great atmosphere coming through the broadcast tonight at Chapman U, hashtag MCLA 2014. That one coming in from the Lacrosse News. And tons of great tweets coming in. We'll get to as many of them as we possibly can. Straker working with Davis behind the cage. 90 seconds to go in the half. Davis working on Dutra. Trying to get upside, playing that two-man game. Gets the pick from Wells, coming inside, trying to get the shot off. Does, but Dutra with the over-the-head check disrupts the pass just enough as that one rolls harmlessly right to Warren Nielsen. Jenkins now with it, has some space through the middle as Arizona State unable to keep up with him through there. And he's showing off his wheels. Again, the team speed for the Chapman Panthers, I don't think could be matched by anyone left in this tournament.
Yeah, we're under a minute to play now in this first half, and you have to imagine that Chapman is going to hold on for the final shot here.
Again, 45 seconds, Rafter with it up top, working on the pole with Jenkins and Aperzezi. Have to think Aperzezi's the one with the green light here as Rafter rolls back. Gets it to Andrews, 30 seconds. Andrews cuts back. Wallace doing a fantastic job on Andrews so far. Gets it to Giannotti. Giannotti by his man. Looking to shoot. Takes the shot. What a save by DeLuca. DeLuca sending it the other direction. Overthrows his man. Giannotti going to be able to pick it up. Run past him. Sends it back inside. 12 seconds to go. As Chapman moving it quickly. There's Ancarlo. Turns the corner. Takes the shot. Scores the goal. And he goes back inside. And let's see what the call is. That one off the pipe. Looked like it hit the back of the net on that one. Goes out of bounds. 4 seconds to go. No goal.
That one was very close, and I want to see a replay of that because it looked like it rung off the left-hand post. A great look from Ancarlo.
Oh, you see it. I mean, the whole goal
moved. It's
actually
off the right-hand post. And yeah, I thought it could have been either way. It heads all the way out of bounds. But man, what a
shot.
You
see that so quick. It moved the whole goal after it hit that post. It looked like the net moved on the back side. All the way up in the press box. Looked like that was a goal. But what a take. As you see the Warren Nielsen face in the crowd. But that one again, you get another look at this one. Off that inside pipe. Slow it all the way down. And it moves the whole goal. That's a real, real tough shot. You see it wobble. But again, no goal off the pipe. What a play. 4 seconds to go, and that's plenty of time when the Panthers are playing Arizona State at home.
Absolutely. 4 seconds remaining in this one. Chris, you got a story on this.
I certainly do. In the 2010 SLC Championship game, Arizona State here taking on the Chapman Panthers. 1 second to go. Chris Small able to find Connor Martin, who buries the goal to tie the game up. Again, just 1 second left in that play. One of the craziest lacrosse plays I have ever seen, and one of my all-time favorite calls. Oh my Martin. Again, 4 seconds to go in this half. 1 goal lead for Arizona State, but Chapman threatening. Andrew's gonna start with it. Probably just gonna have to fire it into the mixer. Tries to send it over, that one picked off. And that's how the half is going to end. And what a half it was. No shortage of excitement.
No, from the get-go, both of these teams know what's on the line. Both of them are playing the games of their lives, especially defensively. I like what I'm seeing out of both these teams. These are very capable offenses that they're facing up against. And they've been doing a great job of containing the star players. Dan Davis hasn't gotten many looks. And Carlo hasn't gotten many looks.
Yeah, we're going to take a look at these goals from the first half. And they were beauties. As you see, the sun's still out. Denis moves the ball down, finds Mikkel, who buries the goal. And Denis again on the front half of this one. As you see it go to Quinn from Piquel back down low. And there's the shot up high for Straker. Here comes Aperzezi inside. The jump shot by Andrews beats DeLuca. Zach Handy turning around, takes the hit. And that's the one that took him out of the game. Again, this one, Herman misjudges the ball. Then Nielsen out of his cage, heads up play by Straker, beats both of them back up above GLE and finishes. That's a high lacrosse IQ play and another quick stick goal coming from Ancarlo, the king of the quick stick. Beats him from way outside. What a save by Nielsen. Moonball. This one all the way up top. See Aperzezi coming across and Marchand finishes the quick stick goal. Chapman really doing well on the crease. But don't go anywhere. The fans are going to be here. We're going to be here. Another half of lacrosse coming your way. For Trey Lanthier, I'm Chris Marshall. Stay tuned.
And welcome back to the 2014 MCLA Championship broadcast. We're here in the semifinal matchup, the nightcap here on day three, as Arizona State taking on the hometown squad, Chapman Panthers.
Yeah, out here at Chaptown, we've got quite the crowd, and we've got a great game on our hands as well. A 4-3 lead for the Sun Devils, but it could go either way at this point. Both offenses are feeling it, and these defenses have been holding them at bay for the most part.
And we see the flag down here as Chapman with an opportunity to go man up as he Cruteau cuts back. And you see them trying to get Jones stuck on the defensive side of the ball. Cruteau again down low. Back to Andrews. Now Giannotti. Rafter by his man. Takes the shot. And that one picked out of the air by Wallace. Going to see a flag going against Arizona State. And that's not how they wanted to start this half.
No, especially with how the faceoffs have gone since Zach Handy is out. Got an update over the halftime break, talked with Zach Handy's father, Jim Handy, who said he is done for the weekend after suffering that hard hit to the head earlier in this one.
Yeah, and you saw the jersey there, split his chin, possible concussion, but definitely taking the precautions, not worth getting him back in the game.
Well, and he's got another year left on his slate at ASU.
See Chapman into their man-up offense. You can see the sideline in the background of Arizona State. Those guys are hopping, trying to feed the energy for this Sun Devil squad. The skip pass to Rafter, thinks about it, skip pass back, pass from the knees, gets it to Kelly, over to Andrews and back up to Rafter. 13 and a half minutes to play in the third. Nice skip pass again as Rafter sends it back up top. Giannotti takes the shot, that one off the stick. It looked like O'Connell going to stay with the Panthers. Back up to Rafter again. They like that cross pass as Giannotti gets it to Kelly. Kelly looking to feed once again. Got tons of great tweets coming inside. There's Ancarlo coming in, and he doesn't miss wide like that very often.
No, he absolutely fanned on that one. An early release, if he had followed through, I think he would have had an easy goal against DeLuca.
Didn't look like he knew he had as much time as he did, but that was the look that Chapman's been trying to build towards as they look again, try to get inside. That one picked off once again by Connell. Connell doing very well, clogging the passing lanes. He dekes that one to himself. That's a fantastic individual effort. Connell brings it across and gets it into the box at just under 13 minutes to play in this third quarter.
And on that last play, a broken stick on the field. Tyler Ancarlo has to head off.
In the rule on the field, if your stick breaks, you have to leave the field. Cannot play without your stick. The officials will come by and pick those pieces up and take them off the field. As it looks like Andrews picked up the top half of Ancarlo's stick, sending it over there just in case he needs that head. 12 and a half minutes to go in the third. Getting tons of tweets coming in. Greg Carroll tweeting in, former ASU goalie. Glad to see the program keeps getting better and better, and they certainly have been doing that. One of the top programs in the nation over the last 5 or 6 years. Great handle by Straker as he's nearly overthrown by Denis. Another one coming in, Tyler Mills tuning in from Jersey, wanting to know how the Panthers can feed off the crowd. And, I mean, it seems like they've been doing that. Started off a little sluggish, but have certainly picked up the pace. And both these teams playing at a very high rate. Denis going to a right. He's very dangerous on the shot from the outside. Under 12 now. Quinn rolls back. Wants Denis. Denis goes to his right. Solid defense by Rafter, keeping him outside. And Denis, a pretty big kid, no easy task keeping him away from the alley.
Yeah, but so far he's really had trouble penetrating aside from a behind-the-back attempt earlier.
And there's Quinn trying to fight through, gets inside, takes the shot. Nielsen with the save, and another save. What a spectacular display by Nielsen inside. Ball down, Cruteau trying to come up with it. Ball punched right back out, and then knocked out of the stick by Dutra of Denis. Dutra gets the ground ball, finds Cruteau. Cruteau rolls back. And we're going to go back and get another look at these Nielsen saves, but Straker knocks the ball out of Cruteau's stick, and that's a fantastic play on the ride from Straker. And we'll get those highlights of those saves from Nielsen as soon as we can. But what a play. I mean, those are two of the best back-to-back saves I've ever seen.
under 11 minutes to play. Arizona State still on the offensive side of the ball. Denis, flip pass. Piquel now going to the right, has the shorty matchup, draws the quick double, rolls away. Wants to go at Rafter again. Rafter, not only a player who gets it done on the offensive side of the ball. Trying to keep Piquel outside, takes the shot. That one off the mark, looks like it's going to be chased down by Davis as it goes out of bounds. Sorry, Straker. Closing in on 10 minutes. There's the shot from outside, and that one off the mark from Piquel as well. Both of these squads having a little trouble get those shots on the cage. Davis looking for Denis. Sorry, that's Quinn. 10 minutes to go in the third. Trying to turn the corner, gets the shot off. Davis has the shorty. That's the matchup Arizona State wants. Gets to Straker. And back over to Davis. Look for the early slide from Croteau as he tries to turn the corner. Croteau's coming, and the ball down. Tries to flip that one in, and another save by Nielsen, and Nielsen out to get it. Looking for Croteau, sending one over the top. Great handle by Croteau. Croteau turns away from it, trying for the rusty gate is Quinn, and that's a pretty heads-up check. And then Connell trying to get it back as that one overthrown by Croteau, looking for Marshawn. Connell running away from pressure, gets it to DeLuca, and that's a very savvy lacrosse play.
Yeah, and how about this back and forth series of games? It's become a defensive game here tonight.
Chapman playing a lot of defense to start this quarter as Arizona State on the offense for nearly 4 minutes at this point. Chapman cannot get the ball back into their settled offense. Very tough ride coming from Arizona State. Let's see what the call is here. Is Arizona State going to get the ball back? There's Beecham. I'm getting a lot of tweets right now. Keep them coming. We'll get to as many of them as we possibly can. But love to hear from you guys at home.
Yeah, Nielsen already nearing that 10 save mark. Feels like he's got twice that already.
And Buck trying to cut back. Gets it into his left. Thinks about the shot and moves it back up top. See Buck and Wells with the shorty matchups right now for Arizona State. 8:15 to go in the third. Buck trying to get by Giannotti. Cuts back across, Ganu's left. Gets the shot off, but not on cage. Straker by his man, trying to turn the corner. Takes the shot. That one off the mark, picked up by Davis, immediately looking to feed. Under eight now. Wells trying to turn the corner. Looking to take the shot, does. And whipped that one wide of the cage.
Yeah, this second midfield line of Finn Wells and Tyler Buck really came alive in that semifinal or in that quarterfinal game against Boston College, but they haven't found their stride here tonight.
Buck with it now, gets the pick, switch on defense by Chapman. Beecham drawing the pull for this second line midfield. Wells by his man, takes the shot, and again just wide as we're now under 7:30 to play in the third.
Still no scores since halftime.
Got a tweet coming in from Lauren Hanneman. ASU has worked so hard this season, definitely deserves the W. And they certainly have had a fantastic season. And there's no team out there in the country that would rather hand them their first loss than this Chapman Panther squad. Wells looking across the crease. Finds the shot, and that one off the pipe, off Giannotti, right to Nielsen.
And for a moment there, nobody knew it was even on the ground until Nielsen had it.
And there's another great ride as Mullen able to pick it up as Straker got in the way of the rest of the Arizona State players trying to go on that ride. And a fortunate play for Chapman, who could have used a bounce going their way at that point. 6:40 to go in the third. Andrews up top to Herman. Herman, Zervis, and now Croteau with the pull.
Yeah, and Herman came to life in that Colorado State game, scored two goals for one of the best offensive games he's seen all season long.
Got another one coming in from Andrew Karolikas as Riley gets it, saying he thinks this one is still anybody's game.
I absolutely agree with that.
Couldn't agree with you more. Shout out to Reagan Kelly from Oliver Madison. Sean Lindsay tweeting in, watching the game. Former Syracuse All-American as well as LXM Pro. Great to hear you enjoying the broadcast. Back up top, Zervis thinks about the shot from outside, looking to feed, cuts through the double, gets back to his right, takes the shot, can't get it off, but picked up by Andrews. Andrews fights through traffic and is able to get back outside. Now 5.5 minutes.
Both teams holding on to possession very well so far in this second half.
Herman coming inside, looked like he had a lane. Looking for Ancarlo, and Carlo gets the quick stick shot off, but McEnany all over his hands. And Marshawn so quick on that change of direction. Connell catches up with him. Moves it to Zervis. Zervis back to Marshawn. Marshawn rolls back, takes the shot, low to high, right into the stick of Andrews. And Andrews, so quick, gets the ball back to Ancarlo. Ancarlo buries his second quick stick goal of the night. Ties this game up.
And that's why he's leading the MCLA in assists right there. The awareness. As soon as he had the ball, he was looking up the field for a man cutting inside to come up with a goal. The Chapman sideline is stoked after that game-tying goal. Let's get another look. Andrews over the top inside for Ancarlo, who did a great job of not entering the crease until after he scored.
Certainly walking the tightrope as you see him go onto his tippy toes as he's able to bury that goal. And at 4-4 with 5 to go in the third, we've got a ball game. And that's a procedure call going against Jones. Chapman having the vast majority of faceoff wins after Handy went out. Now Marshawn with it. Under 5 to play in the third.
Yeah, they're actually 6-1 since Handy left in the faceoff circle.
Marshawn still working on Connell. Now Miller, Jenkin, and Laviola. .430 to go in the third.
Yeah, and this play's starting to get a little quiet as the intensity starts to settle in a little.
Now Andrews. Jenkin and back up to Laviola. Quick double coming from the crease. And Carlo now with some space. Back up to Welch. The second line midfield for the Panthers, getting a lot of love right now from Coach Hartley. Playing well. Marshawn cuts back again. And for a third time, comes around the corner, takes the shot, the diving effort. Can't quite get it in. And that one's going to stay with the Panthers on a great hustle play for Laviola, able to outrun Brash.
Yeah, and Connell's long pull got to the Marshawn just before he released it.
Welch trying to turn the corner, always looking to feed that crease. And that one picked off, and that's a great play from McEnany as he snatched that one out of the air.
Yeah, and Andrews, a bit of a miscommunication there. He thought his man would be staying in place, but instead tried for a cut inside, and McEnany had the easy pickoff.
Again, 3:20 to go in the third. Chapman trying to force DeLuca to bring it up himself as the crowd comes back to life. And DeLuca again takes it across the midline. Already has one shot. And that's going to be a failure to advance. And Chapman gets exactly what they want, sending the ball up the field. Now Jenkin has it. Chapman moving forward with numbers. Under 3 to play in the third. Still all tied up at 4. Got a tweet coming in. This one from Matt Blamey. Chromecast plus broadcast equals a great Thursday evening. Awesome environment at Chapman tonight. Hashtag MCLA 2014. And there you see Jenkin running across, trying to create a numbers problem for the Panthers. And you see Chapman subbing through the midline, looking for matchups. Aperzezi now in. Back to that first line. Giannotti, Aperzezi, and Rafter. Really pick your poison up top. Now Aperzezi. Connell up on Aperzezi. As Chapman finally gets their sixth player down to the offensive side of the field. It's like Arizona State may have dropped into a little bit of a zone look here. Trying to combat those crease passes. Andrews cuts by Wallace. Almost runs into the official. And that's something we've seen Andrews do, use the official as a block.
Yeah, use anything you can to your advantage.
Under 2 minutes in the third quarter now. Now Brzezzi trying to get by Connell, thinks about it, quick double, moves it down to Kelly. Kelly back up top. Giannotti with the shot. That one falls out of his stick before he can get the shot going. Hillier with the ball, and he went coast to coast in the first half, and Chapman running him down. Minute 15 seconds to go, 4-4. As Arizona State now with the ball on the offensive side.
And you have to imagine they're going to run out for the final shot here. Usually this is a place in which Coach Malone will call a timeout.
And there's the shot. That one off the mark. And very close to Nielsen being the back man there as Straker just gets behind him. Under a minute now to play in the third. Denis has the matchup going against Herman. Herman, a very capable short stick defender, but giving up a lot of size. Does look like Denis trying to wave off Beecham. Denis at 6'5", 210 pounds. A big kid as he's going to hold on to the last shot here. 30 seconds to go in the third. The defense chant getting louder from the sideline. 25 seconds. Herman just letting him stand. Trying to get the pick play with Beecham. Trying to create some space. Gets the switch with Giannotti. Turns the corner. Feeds inside. Buries the goal. What a shot with 12 seconds to go to put Arizona State back up by one.
And that is a beautiful execution. That's exactly how that play was designed. He got the pick, got the matchup he wanted, made not one, but two spin moves, and was able to free up enough space to send this one to the back of the net. Look at this beautiful play by Denis. Turns one way, turns the other, and puts it top shelf.
And they couldn't put that any further into the top corner as he's able to beat Nielsen.
Kyle Denis clearly stoked about scoring that one. That's a 5-4 lead now for the Sun Devils with 12 seconds left in this third quarter.
Jones able to win it to himself, going the other direction. No one coming to him as he takes the shot. Big save by Nielsen. Ball still down, 3 seconds to go. There's a buries the goal, 1 second left on the clock. And Dan Davis and the Arizona State fans come to life.
That is unbelievable. A huge momentum swing as ASU finds two goals in the final 12 seconds of this quarter to take a two-goal lead and break the tie. 1 second is on the scoreboard right now. 1 second. And you give credit to Cortland Jones for setting that one up. He's able to win the faceoff, immediately get back the other direction. Just a great play from the start. And look at Dan Davis right here getting right on in here, scooping up the loose change and putting it away over the shoulder of Warren Nielsen.
And that one's on the defense as Nielsen makes a big save to keep that one out of the cage on the first shot from Jones. And then the trail shot coming from Davis punishes the Panthers. We got a great fourth quarter of action coming your way. But first, let's hear Coach Malone's take on the SLC-RMLC rivalry.
I think the RMLC has kind of been that conference that with BYU and Colorado State and Colorado having all the success they've had over the last 4 or 5 years, I think our conference has caught up to them. And, you know, I think it would be a great debate, you know, amongst the coaches around the country to see which conference is truly the best. And I think with this, with the three teams in the Final Four, I think you have to say for 2014, the SLC is a little stronger than the RMLC.
And there you have it. Coach Malone coming out and saying it. Three SLC teams in the Final Four this year, one RMLC team. I don't think there's any doubt that those are the two top teams in the nation, two top leagues in the nation. But SLC certainly making a claim to the top.
Well, and looking at the fans showing here tonight might be enough to prove that the SLC has attracted enough attention. They put up powerhouse programs year in, year out. And right now, two SLC teams, probably the best two teams in the SLC over its history, are going at it for a chance to head on to the championship, where they'll play Colorado, who just knocked off Santa Barbara in a very close finish earlier today.
Absolutely, and I believe the only two teams ever to win SLC championships. As we have a bunch of boys tweeting in at us, Mac S tuning in, hashtag Roll Town. Our boys are battling. Got a picture of that great end zone cam. Got another tweet coming in, this one from ASAP Tomzy. Watching the big bro and his roommate in style, go big Tomei Siegel and Chaptown, hashtag Roll Town. A lot of tweets coming in. And this one coming in from Jordan Goldberg. Love the showing from the SLC, especially that livid crowd in the Final Four from a Northern Arizona Lax player. And they've gone back to Croteau at the faceoff X as the ball picked up and then thrown over the head. And that one picked up by Connell as a fantastic play as he stays in the box but able to pick up the ball with his stick and head right back down to the offensive side of the field. Arizona, two gigantic goals to end that quarter. As we see the flag come down, and Cooper Pickell come inside, lose the handle, ball down, picked up by Croteau, and I think that's gonna be a push going against Chapman.
Yeah, and you talk about that final sequence in the third quarter in which we saw Kyle Denis hold on for what was supposed to be the final play, ends up scoring with 12 seconds left, and Cortland Jones wins the ensuing faceoff, only his second faceoff win of the night, and is able to take it all the way in the other direction, take a shot. Dan Davis scoops up the rebound, puts it away, and that's how we got where we're at a 6-4 game. But do not count Chapman out. This is a team that can be streaky, but they can get on a run so fast, especially with how many athletes they have and the way they can move in the opposite direction so fast. But they'll be man down right here, Chris, and this is a big-time play for both of these teams.
Yeah, no team able to get out to a lead more than two goals here in either game, aside from Santa Barbara, who went up 3-0 to start that game, but that the largest of the day for either of these squads. And there's a great trail check, and that one coming in, but unable to find that far side of the goal is Cooper Pickell. You see Straker on the dive attempt, but knocked out of his stick by Alex Siegel. All the way back up top, and just about ready to get back to full strength as Chapman sends Riley back in. And a little bit of a hidden ball trick. Davis has it, moves it up top to Beecham. And that one picked off by Riley and then off his stick right back to Beecham. Beecham tries to move it to Straker. And as we're a minute gone in this fourth quarter, Denis gets the ball back with that same matchup that he had when he scored that last goal. Calling for the pick play with Cooper Pickell. He's working on Riley and Herman. And for some left, he rolls back, gets the switch. Rolls back again, tries to get it to his left. Looks like he wants to take the shot. Still battling as he's going up against Riley. Riley giving a lot of size up as the freshman, only 5'9". Denis looking inside. There's a big slide coming from Dutra. Dutra lets him know that he's coming. As you see Pickell back to Denis. Denis doesn't have the angle, moves it to Quinn. Back down low, can't find his man. And that one's headed back towards the midline. Under 13 minutes to go now. See Quinn trying to get past his man. Looks inside, takes the shot. That one off the mark. But it's going to be backed up by Pickell.
I think Nielsen might have gotten a piece of that one with his elbow.
You can hear the call coming in from the sideline. Pickell with it to start. Now Henry Archie making one of his first appearances of the game.
Yeah, Archie usually sees much more time in the defensive unit, but clearly Coach Malone has developed a lot of trust in him playing up top on this midfield line.
And holding the ball as they get their offensive unit onto the field, kind of surprised not to see a timer on call here, as he hadn't made any sort of movement towards the cage. Now going left, moves it below, cuts back, has his man hung up, takes the shot. Looks like Siegel's going to be able to run this down. And that's a huge play for the Panthers. They need something to go their way on the offensive side of the field.
Yeah, as it's really been a while since we've seen that Chapman Panther offense.
There's crossfield pass to Siegel. Siegel plays the bounce well. Both these teams going into that high-pressure ride. Siegel looks like he's going to be able to get it across himself. Looking for that man inside, finds Giannotti. Giannotti into Ancarlo, and Carlo trying to make that extra pass, but knocked out of the air.
And that's a big play from Ian Connell, who actually came up with a similar play against Boston College to preserve a goal from being scored in that one.
And, you know, I'd like to see Ancarlo take the shot there. I like the unselfish play, but he definitely had an angle there. As Arizona State moves the ball up, here's Wells. We got a tweet coming in from Connor Martin, Mr. Conbro Chill himself. Oh, baby, watching this game and tingles in my jingles. Go Chaptown. Wells working from up top, under 11 to play. Still holding on to that two-goal lead. By Herman. Can't get the shot off. Wells wants to take another run.
Yeah, and Arizona State's been playing a very slow set offense in this quarter.
Goes to the right side, working on Herman again. Wants the shot, takes it. Nielsen, no problem. As he rolls out back around the cage. Over to Dutra. 10 minutes to go. Crossfield pass to Mullins. Mullen through. Gets it to Herman. Herman into the box, playing on Buck. Now Marshawn. Rafter yet to get on the score sheet as he gets the ball back.
Hey, Rafter, a guy who stepped up big in that game against Colorado State. As you might not have stuffed the stat sheet so much, but he was definitely there and a big cog in the offensive unit.
9:20 to go in the game. Panthers still looking for some offense in this quarter. Rafter to Giannotti. Giannotti has the shorty. Beecham moves it down low. Kelly thinks about running up, but Connell is there to meet him. Now Brzezzi. By his man, all the way across the crease. There's the shot, big save by DeLuca, as Kelly can't beat him. Now McEnany gonna bring the ball across the midline. See the pull, that's a great sub by Chapman, as you see Croteau come out at the bottom as Aprazzese steps in at the top to cut off McEnany.
And this ASU offense gonna get a chance to set up once more and playing a very slow style ever since that ending play in the third quarter in which they had Kyle Denis posted all the way on the far sideline, slowing things up. They must have liked what they saw out of that because they've been really, really letting this clock wind out a little here.
Definitely doing a little strategery, taking some time off the clock, getting the ball back up to Pikel. We haven't seen a timer on called yet in this game. Denis now, as we come past the 8-minute mark to go in this game. Neither team able to get on the board in this fourth quarter yet. Straker working on Nickelman. Gagne moves it up top. Denis coming inside, has the matchup with Rafter. 7.5 minutes to go.
Still no timer on call.
And that's a full minute and 10 seconds without any movement towards the cage.
definitely a calculated time milking technique.
Yeah, and remember, this is something ASU did against Colorado State, or actually against Colorado, back when they played in early March. Took a lead and then just milked the clock till the end.
See, Davis again moves the ball back up top to Quinn. Turns the corner, takes the shot. Nielsen with a big save. Courteau with it. Mullen coming up the far side, finds him. Mullen working down the field. There's three pulls on offense for Chapman right now. Mullen flips it back to Marshawn. Marshawn to Ancarlo and back up to Andrews. Again, that was three pulls coming across on offense for Chapman. And no fear.
And you can see a jump in the step of these Chapman Panthers following Nielsen's 11th save of the night.
And a bunch more tweets coming in as Guinevere Pirot tunes in. Arizona State doing a great job. Big save by DeLuca as, again, Connell turning the tide against Marshawn. Arizona State able to take 2 full minutes off the clock on their last possession. Chapman's got to start pressuring out.
Yeah, Genevieve Perrot, actually an ASU volleyball player on that NCAA Division I team.
Got another shout out coming from Christian Main to the big homie Billy Main. Let's get this ASU. Another one coming in from Connor Martin. Can't believe you read that out loud. Believe it. It happened. As Arizona State with it again, that's Wells. Already taking another 30 seconds off the clock. You see Malone telling, Coach Malone sending his guy up top as Gagne gonna sub back in for Quinn. Timer on call, first one of the game. ASU now has 30 seconds to get a shot on Cage. Quinn looking up top. There's Straker in a little bit of an invert set. Buck, Straker, Quinn up top. Wells now. 5 minutes to play. Wells trying to get by Herman. Does, takes the shot, scores the goal, and that's a huge goal for Arizona State as that pushes the lead to 3 at 7-4.
And you can see Coach Malone happy his strategy worked out there. Finally gets the timer on call. Finn Wells able to create some space and put that one home. Wells went low on that attempt, and he's part of that second line that Coach Malone wanted to see start lighting it up in this tournament, and they've done that today. As you can see right here, Wells blows by his man and just goes across his body down low left corner of Warren Martin-World Nielsen.
And back to the faceoff. And that one won backwards. Jacob trying to get it. That one kicked out. Connell has a line on it. Marshawn able to pick it up. Ball knocked out of his stick. Ball still down as McEnany kicks it back up. Gets it to Hillier. Hillier trying to fight through. Big ride from Marshawn as he fires his stick all the way into the crowd. And there's the shot and another goal. That one coming from Quinn, and that's a huge play as Arizona State starting to put the nails in the coffin.
They have come alive as of late here, and it all started at the end of that third quarter. The momentum has shifted massively in the favor of ASU, and you can still hear the crowd, and that's how many ASU fans are in attendance as Logan Quinn putting that one away on the great transition opportunity. Nick Hillier has been having a heck of a game for himself.
And puts it right in the corner, knocks the water bottle out of the cage. Can't put it in a better spot as you see him find that bottom left corner of the goal. And Jenkins trying to get it in the back of the stick of Jones, able to come up with a faceoff finally here in this fourth quarter. Looks to find Kelly, and that one on the outside of the cage as DeLuca comes out, takes a high hit, draws the flag. And that one's gonna be an Ancarlo. With 4 minutes and 18 seconds to go, that is not what Chapman needed.
And I'd like to see a replay of that hit as DeLuca had rolled back out of his cage. And you can see right here, a shot off the side of the net. DeLuca comes in.
And clearly a high hit there. I mean, definitely deserved the penalty. And that one's going to be going against Ancarlo. And Arizona State is going to be man up 4 with 4 to play. And there is no timer on while they are man up. So I have to think that they're just going to camp out in the corner and take as much time off the clock as they can as Denis brings it in.
And this possession could very well be the end of the start of the end for Chapman here. A four-goal lead with 4 minutes to play. Certainly a game that Chapman can come back into, but they have to get a stop here.
Denis just holding it up top. A couple more tweets coming in. Brianna Figueroa. Nobody deserves it more than ASU. They're 18-0 for a reason, and they certainly are. Had this conversation with Coach Malone before the game, and they're grinders. They want to get in there, and they just grind. Once they get a hold in the goal, they're able to get ahead, and they grind games out. Is that one inside? Gagne trying to get the shot off, does, but the save by Nielsen once again. Back up top, Pikel moves it again, and there's Denis. Right back to Pikel. Pikel thinking about the shot, takes it and buries it top shelf. And that might just about do it with 3.5 to go. That's three straight for Arizona State.
And the defense gave Cooper Pikel a little too much space to work with there, and he puts it home. Not much Warren Nielsen can do there to stop that one, as you can tell this Chapman team feeling demoralized after this recent run. That's
see
the second look.
That cross crease pass, and then there's no question about this. Takes a crow hop, finishes top left. Couldn't have put that any further
in
the corner.
That was in the corner.
Got another tweet coming in from UCF head coach James Foote. High lacrosse IQ being displayed in this MCLA 2014 semifinal. And couldn't agree more. Both of these teams, it's a shame somebody has to lose, because both of these teams are so good, so many talented players, and another face-off win for Jones, who tries to send it back in, but unable to do so. Five-goal lead, 3:12 to go. You see a timeout call coming from the sideline.
And the fans... For the Arizona State side, pretty amped up as the Chapman crowd has died down out here in Ernie Chapman Stadium. 3:12 is on the clock. Down 5 are the Chapman Panthers, the 4 seed. This game was tied as recently as 4 apiece, and Arizona State has really created separation. 5 unanswered goals since the final 12 seconds of that third quarter.
And I think that was really the game-changing moment that you can look back on and say, this is what really broke it open for Arizona State. It was Dan Davis scoring that goal with 1 second to go. I mean, the Denis one hurt, and I think the Dan Davis one put these Panthers to bed.
Yeah, and they haven't had the same level of energy as another look at the Cooper Pikel goal that just extended this lead to 5. Just a great look from Pikel, and actually hits the crossbar on its way in.
And you see, he is fired up. And that's the thing. It's a very fundamental shot. He goes overhead shot, up and down on the angle with his head there, and just buries that one. That's exactly how you're supposed to do it.
Yeah, and ASU is 3 minutes and 12 seconds away from making the national championship game, as Chapman going to need a miracle to make the comeback in this one.
And here's another tweet coming in, this one from Kat Pearson. There we go, ASU, keep it up. Let's pull out the W, hashtag go Devils, and a bunch of fire emoticons. Those are one of my favorites.
Emoticons.
Thanks, Kat. That's exciting. Connor Martin coming out, tweeting at Chapman Lax, tweeting at ASU Lax. I remember when we used to have 30-goal games between us, shot clock, hashtag for the kids. And those were the days, tell you what, a Chapman team in 2008 and 9 averaging nearly 20 goals a game. As that one comes around the corner, and another goal, this one from Straker, and Nielsen goes down.
Justin Straker completes the hat trick as he had 2 in the first half, scores his first of the second half right there, and Nielsen was coming out of the cage. They had to put some pressure all around, and Straker took advantage. ASU 6 unanswered goals.
And, I mean, there's nothing you can do about that one if you're Nielsen. I mean, he's a guy who has had one heck of a career for the Panthers, as you see him go down. I mean, he's disappointed. And he's the type of guy who takes this sort of thing really, really hard. But he's got to hang his head high. He had a heck of a season and a heck of a career here at Chapman.
Well, Well, not only that, but what a game from him in the quarterfinal matchup with Colorado State. Probably played the game of his life. And the reality is he hasn't played that badly here tonight. He's come up with a lot of saves. This ASU offense just keeps getting shots on him.
And that's what we talked about. And they're grinders, and they're out here trying to get this victory. Now we're under 3 minutes to play. That one across the crease finds Ancarlo, but knocked out of the stick by McEnany, and everything going the Sun Devils' way right now.
Yeah, and fans have been calling this a season of destiny, the season of first, as they finish undefeated for the first time and now trying to win a championship for the first time.
And Hillier going for the shot, and it looks like Dutra got a touch on that one to force that one out. We see a timeout coming from the Chapman sideline as they want to try and draw something up on defense here with 2:19 to go in this game and a 6-goal deficit.
Yeah, and it's hard to imagine a comeback for Chapman this time around as you see them on the sideline. They're still going to come into this huddle, and you know they're going to come out fighting. There's no doubt that this team will go down swinging.
Yeah, and these are teams that, you know, have a long history. I mean, you see Connor Martin tweeting in, of course, you know, of the Ohio Machine, former Chapman All-American, you know, doing big things in the MLL. And it's like I was at that game between Chapman and Arizona State where they're able to erase a 7-goal deficit from the first quarter to come back and win that 18-16. And those are the Chapman-Arizona State games that legends are made of. When you score 34 goals between you in a semifinal game in Cowboy Stadium, it's I still get butterflies talking about it.
The history between these two programs runs so deep, and like you said earlier, Chris, you hate to see either one of these teams go down right now, but it's ASU who has shown up to play. A tweet coming in from former ASU goalie Ryan Davis as he Cooper Bickell just took Chaptown to Rip City regarding that last goal that he fired home.
Yeah, and that was a fantastic shot. I mean, Arizona State just able to outlast the Panthers here tonight. A lot of heat coming out on the field today, and the Devils living in the fire here. You see the ASU chant coming from the sideline as Straker able to get by Nielsen. It's like he's going to pull this one out. Takes one from Nickelman. Straker running away from the goal, opting not to shoot it. 2 minutes trying to get away. And then Nickelman knocks the ball out of his stick, and that's a great hustle play, diving to sell out, sending that one up the field. As Zach Dutra down, looking for his man, gets it to Riley, over to Marshawn. Marshawn can't handle it, but able to come up with it. 1:45 to go in the game. Andrews with it now. See Dutra come back across the midline. And Croteau going back up top. There's Ancarlo, takes the shot and scores the goal. Cuts the lead to 5 with 98 seconds to go.
And you got to love the crowd still having a resounding cheer after Ancarlo scores here. This game may still be out of reach. 98 seconds on the clock, but a 5-goal deficit is not easy to overcome. And let's take another look at Ancarlo's strike. And Andrews, just a beautiful pass. And that's why he's the leading assist getter in the MCLA, as Ancarlo just puts it home.
Yeah, and a huge moment for Andrews as well, as he eclipses 50 assists for the season. I mean, that's a fantastic year. Jenkins coming inside, thinks about the shot. They need to start shooting if they want to even have a breath of a chance. Marshawn cutting back, 1:23. Goes for the air gate dunk shot. That one saved by DeLuca, and Hillier able to come up with it, trying to find someone, moves it up to McEnany. McEnany looks like he's going to be able to outrun Andrews, and Andrews comes across, takes the cone with him. Waddella inside, now down to a minute to play as Jenkins gets Waddella in the back. All the way across the field, gets it to Denis, and Denis moves it to Quinn. Holding on to that 5-goal lead, working on Mullen. Runs away from Mullen. Mullen trying to throw the wrap check. Now caught up by Nickelman.
You can see the Arizona State fans getting excited, and they are ready to celebrate.
And loses the handle. And we're going to see a timeout by Arizona State with 37 seconds to go.
Up 5 goals. Chapman definitely putting up a fight here, and you have to respect that. And these two teams definitely have a lot of respect for each other, and you want to see this game end at the buzzer, you know, not with a couple minutes left. So You're expecting to see both these teams keep getting shots on, but ASU fans are clearly pleased with the result they've seen on the field here tonight.
Well, and here's a tweet coming in from Ben Clark. Jones is no Handy, but that kid battles. And, I mean, I think the game ball has to go to Jones.
That's a great point. That's a great point. He's a guy we haven't talked about too much, but filling in the shoes of Zach Handy is probably one of the hardest things to do, seeing as there's nobody better at what Handy does, and he had to come in the middle of this game and play that role. And he came up with the pivotal face-off win that went the other direction and turned the tides in this game.
And make sure to join the discussion. Tweet at @the_MCLA, #MCLA2014, and make sure to send us your tweets as well, @CMarshallTLN and @TreyLanthier. Love to hear from all of you. Got a bunch more tweets coming in. This one from Riley Horton. ASU lacrosse representing Arizona the right way tonight, from NAU lacrosse. And another tweet coming in from former Chapman attackman. Hell of a ride turning things around this season. Still proud of Chaptown Lacs, especially those seniors. And a lot of pride for both of these programs. A lot of former players tuning in, tweeting in. I mean, they all still care.
Yeah, and KDJ sending in, killing it, you Lax Devils. Bring on the Buffs, as that's looking like a great championship matchup between the one seed and the two seed in all of the MCLA.
Ball coming in, and the double team going. As the ball goes down, Chapman able to come away with it. Takes a big hit. That's Nickelman. Can't come up with the ground ball. Finally picked up. There's Nielsen out of his cage, trying to get the ball away. Cannot do so, as Rhett Rogers coming away, trying to get away from this high-pressure Chapman defense. Barely able to do so. Still keeps it in his stick somehow. As we get down to the last 10 seconds here, draws the flag, and the ball going up top. As John McCallum into the game, we've seen some guys we haven't seen yet able to run this clock off. And 1 second, that's going to do it. That's how it's going to end. Arizona State out to get their goalie, DeLuca. The Chapman team dejected, to say the least, as they're out to get their seniors. You see Warren Nielsen go down, and all the guys out to get him.
Yeah, and ASU has every reason to celebrate, as they played a heck of a game, and they played a heck of an opponent in Chapman. This is not a team that goes down easy, and ASU made it look easy. They take this one 10-5, and they have had Chapman's number this season. But give credit to the Panthers, putting together a heck of a run. They came close, and in none of their previous games in the tournament, they were able to handle Colorado State, the back-to-back champions in the last round, before falling here to the Sun Devils.
And the Chapman Panthers picking up their seniors. As you see, Warren Nielsen hit the deck, Dutra hit the deck, Nickelman hit the deck. All those guys, as you see all their teammates, come pick them up off the ground, take them back to the sideline. Nothing but love for those guys coming to get them. A tough-fought season, great year for the Panthers. Just didn't have enough to take down the undefeated number one team in the land, Arizona State.
Well, and you know, there's a reason this team is undefeated right now. They've played from start to finish in every game that they played in, and they've earned it to their way to this championship game. They've earned it in every way, shape, and form. And you look at how they played against Chapman in Chapman Stadium. That is a phenomenal feat. And they're going to take on the Colorado Buffs in the next round, which should be one of the games of the year in the MCLA.
I mean, if they can overcome losing Zach Handy, coming into what has to be the most hostile environment they've ever played in, and come away with the victory, these guys can do anything.
And a convincing victory at that.
And this broadcast was produced in partnership with the Lacrosse Network. Make sure to tweet at @the_MCLA. Use #MCLA2014. Tell us what you think about the broadcast. Tell us what you like. Love to hear from all of you at home. Very happy to be able to bring you this very high level of lacrosse. And can't wait to hear what Joe Paris down at the field is going to see coming from the interview that's going to be up later on. But thanks so much for tuning in. Very happy that all of you were able to watch this game. Tweet in your thoughts, your comments. Can't wait to read the comments on the feed as well. With Trey Lanthier, I'm Chris Marshall. And stay laxy.